Hi guys, I'm Kim and today I'm going to bring you a review of Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. So first off, let me say two things. First, there is a spoiler part at the end of the video, but until then the video is spoiler free, so you can watch it even if you have not read the book and do not want to be spoiled. The second thing is, this video is going to be incredibly rambly because I cannot talk about this book without making a connection to Harry Potter. I cannot rate this book without comparing it to Harry Potter, or I did rate it without comparing it to Harry Potter, but I cannot review it without comparing it to Harry Potter. I cannot talk about this book without talking about Harry Potter, and whenever I talk about Harry Potter, it's going to be incredibly rambly and I'm going to just ramble on forever and ever and ever. So I'm trying to keep this short, to not make it last forever and be me talking about Harry Potter in the end. So I'm really, really trying to actually talk about this book and not talk about Harry Potter. And talking about Harry Potter, maybe I should say this at the beginning of the video so you can like think about it while you watch this video. I'm thinking about making videos about the Harry Potter books, like one for each year, but not have them be reviews about like the book itself, more being me talking about this world as if it was real and talking about what I thought about it. So maybe you could say it's a review, but I do not want to actually review the book as in, okay, the book was written well, or this J.K. Rowling made a mistake in this or whatever. No, it's going to be me being like, what the hell was Dumbledore thinking, and why do the wizards do it like this? The wizards, why don't they do it like this? Why is this happening? So it's kind of a review, but kind of not. And after you watch this video, you will kind of see how those videos will be going. So please keep it in mind and then tell me if you would like to see those kinds of video or you wouldn't. So as for the book, in case you've just been sitting there and thinking like, what is she talking about? We're talking about Carry On and not Harry Potter. Where is the connection? Let me tell you about Carry On. Or let me tell you about Fangirl. Fangirl is a book by Rainbow Rowell that was published before this one was. And Fangirl is a contemporary book about this girl named Kath. I believe I have not read Fangirl, so I'm not 100% sure everything I'm telling you about Fangirl is accurate, but just the basics so you understand this book better. So Kath is a girl who's going to university and she's kind of introvert, I think, and she writes fanfiction. And essentially she's writing dreary fanfiction. But the fanfiction is not about Draco Malfoy and Harry Potter, and she's not reading the Harry Potter books. She is reading the Simon Snow books, and the fanfiction is about Simon Snow and bears. There are, in Fangirl, there are 7 Simon Snow books. I'm not sure exactly how in-depth they're being talked about because the book is about Kath and fanfiction writing is her hobby, but the book is about her, not about those other books. So, the difference between, or one of the differences between Simon Snow and Harry Potter is that there are 8 years at the school Simon Snow goes to, and so there are 8 books. Although Kath has only access to 7 books, there have only been 7 books published in her contemporary world. In the real world, there's only 1 book published, and it is the 8th book. So this is year 8 at Wedford, which is the magician school. And yeah, so there is this one book which is the 8th book in a series of 7 books, in a series of 8 books, but the first 7 books do not exist except in this Fangirl universe. Okay, so does this kind of make sense? I hope it does. Yeah, so let's get into Carry On. First of all, as I said, I cannot view this book separately from Harry Potter. I rated it separately. I rated it 4 stars. If I compared it to Harry Potter, it probably, well, it might still have gotten 4 stars. It probably would have gotten like 3 stars or whatever, but I try not to compare books to Harry Potter and rating them because there is just hardly anything that's as good as Harry Potter. So I try not to compare it when rating, but when reviewing, I have to compare this book to Harry Potter because when reading it, I compared it to Harry Potter. So maybe if you've not read Harry Potter, or if you've only read it once and it's a long time ago and you don't remember much about the books, maybe you could read this book without thinking about Harry Potter. But if you've got the Harry Potter books in your head and you're pretty sure about the whole world it takes place in, you will think about Harry Potter when reading this book. But it is its own book. It has its own plot, it has its own world, it has its own characters, and I think that's very important. This is kind of like a retelling. It's like ACOTAR is a retelling of Beauty and the Beast. Like, the base of the story is kind of the same, or you can see the parallels, but it's completely its own story. Or what I think about, I've not read the Lunar Chronicles, but I think it's kind of similar again as the Lunar Chronicles. So the Lunar Chronicles are retellings of fairy tales, but they're their own stories, and I think that's kind of what happened with this book. Like, it has Harry Potter as its base, but it's its own book. So let's start with the plot. The plot is interesting, but it is pretty similar to Harry Potter, and also the plot in Harry Potter, it's pretty much as it is here. The boy hero, the chosen one, the boy wonder, he has to defeat this big bad evil, in this case the Humdrum. Yes, Humdrum, Humdinger, Humdinger. So the evil is the Humdrum, and Simon has to defeat it. So that's a pretty basic plot, but again, the plot wasn't invented by J.K. Rowling when she wrote Harry Potter. That's just a pretty basic plot to begin with, but it is very interesting. I think the twist at the end, like what or who the Humdrum really is very interesting. It's something I did not expect, and it's certainly something that she has written well. And she has written the whole book well, so I think her writing style is very good. It flows very easily, it's very easy to read, and it's a very good book, and it's very well written. So I've talked about the plot. Let's talk about the characters. There are three or maybe four characters where you can see the distinct parallels to Harry Potter, even though they have their own personalities and they are their own characters. The first one obviously is Simon Snow. He is the chosen one, the boy wanderer. He is an orphan. He has to defeat the big bad evil. That's pretty much the same as Harry Potter. And his character does have similarities to Harry Potter, but he is still his own character. So it's not just Harry Potter with a different name. He is his own character, he has his own personality. Same goes for Bess. Bess is the nemesis of Simon Snow, his arch enemy, at least when it comes to school, and you exclude the Humdrum. And he is from one of the old families. He is posh and snobby and whatnot. And you can definitely see the parallels to Draco Malfoy, but again, he has his own personality and is his own character. Then the third one, and probably the most similar one, is the mage, who is the headmaster of Wedford, which is the magic school, and obviously headmaster Dumbledore, the mage. As Dumbledore, the mage is not only headmaster, he has also responsibilities to a greater good, obviously, but also like the ICW, it's called in Harry Potter the International Confederation of Wizards. There is something similar in this book, although I have forgotten its name. And he's also very involved in that one. And he has his own group. They're called the Mage's Men, and they're similar to the Order of the Phoenix. They work for the mage and try to help him defeat the Humdrum, as well as take over the world, as well as like deal with the old families. So here you can see more of a parallel. And here there's something, he is different than Dumbledore is written in the books, but he's exactly like I believe Dumbledore to truly be. So obviously that's something that I will talk more about if I do those Harry Potter videos, and it's also something I will talk more about in the spoiler section, because that's kind of a spoiler, that's kind of a reveal, although you can probably imagine what it is now. But yeah, That's that, and then the last one obviously is the Humdrum and Voldemort. They are very different. Again, this is a spoiler part about who or what the Humdrum really is. That's kind of a reveal that is at the very end of the book. That's very like important. So I'm not going to talk about it now. But obviously you can see the parallels, like the big bad evil, like who's trying to take over the world and whatever. Obviously you can see the parallels. But again, it's very different. It's very it's very much Rainbow's own story and not just something copied off of J.K. Rowling. As for all the other characters, I do not think you can truly see parallels. You can, if you really want to, for example, Penny, who is Simon's best friend, she has a lot of siblings. Her oldest one is working for the mage. So you could say Ron has a lot of siblings and his oldest siblings are part of the Order of the Phoenix and are working for Dumbledore, so there are your parallels. Well, you could do that, but let me tell you one thing. Penny has nothing to do with Ronald Weasley. She's very much her own person. She's very much a person I would be very much more happy, and that didn't make any sense. She's very much a person I would be very much more happy again. It doesn't make sense. I would very much prefer Penny to be my friend over Ronald, because I do not like Ronald Weasley at all. Again, something for those Harry Potter videos. But even so, Penny is a very different person. She has a very own character. She's very unique. She is so much more than just a blend between Hermione and Ron, which some people are saying she is. And if you really, really wanted to completely put everything in comparison to Harry Potter, to find for everything that is happening here a parallel in Harry Potter, yes, she kind of would be Hermione and Ron in one, but she isn't. She is her own person and she's a really great person. Also, all of the other characters that are mentioned are very much their own characters. I could not find someone similar in the Harry Potter books, even though I could find someone that like has the parallels when it comes to which side they're on and which family they belong to. But when it comes to them, the persons themselves, the characters themselves, their personalities, they're very different and very much their own. Then the next thing is the world this is taking place in, and again there are similarities, but there are also a lot of differences. And the first one is that while there are the old families who are fighting to keep their culture alive, they are not fighting for blood, and no one really cares about whether, well, how am I going to say this? Everyone lives in Muggle areas. There are no wizarding settlements. Everyone is just intermingled with the Muggles. Although I think they're called normals in this book, and they do not know about magic. But everyone, even Bass's family, they have normal neighbors, they have laptops, they have phones, they use pens, probably. I'm not sure about the pens. I don't think you really read about them writing something, but they use laptops and phones, so that's that. Although, phones and I think laptops as well are banned from Redford, but not because they do not work there, but because the mage, I think he thinks they stop people from concentrating on schoolwork, whatever. But yeah, so everyone is using laptops and phones and they're texting instead of sending owls, which is amazing and exactly what I've always wanted. Like, why would wizards be so closed off? Even the light wizards, who are all four Muggleborns, why would they not take advantage of the technologies? Like, why? I don't get it. Like, and that's the way it works here. Like, everyone is taking advantage of Muggle technologies, but the old families still want to keep their traditions alive, which is something I can understand. And something that I really like to read about in Harry Potter fanfiction. But again, that's another story, and I'm afraid this video is going to be way too long. One thing that's different that I don't like as much is the way magic works. So first of all, and this isn't the part I don't like, this part it's okay, I don't really mind either way, is you do not have to use a wand. Everyone has their focus, and for some people that's a wand. That usually runs in a family, so Bess's family is a wand-wielding family, so they usually have a wand as their focus. Penny has a ring, I believe, so you have different kind of things. There's one boy who has his belt buckle as his focus, so I can only imagine how he's casting spells. But so that's the one thing. But the main thing is that the magic is infused in the words you speak, and the spells aren't just like Latin spells or whatever. They're more like you say what you want and then infuse your words with your magic. So they're in English, and they're usually like, maybe they're phrases from like a song or just like a saying or something like this, and you infuse this with magic. Also, you can just infuse anything with magic. I think those sayings or whatever, they are more powerful the more they are still in people's minds. So if you use something ancient, it wouldn't work or wouldn't work as well, because it's not only your magic that goes into whatever you're saying, but it's also important how well this saying is still in people's minds. I don't know, it's kind of like a very famous children's song or whatever has a lot more power than maybe something else, because this song is still very, very much in people's minds. I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain. It makes more sense if you read it, but I don't think it makes any sense at all what I'm telling you, but that's how it is. Also, you don't have to be careful about what you say if you're just talking, because you have to consciously infuse the words with your magic to cast a spell. So you can say something when it goes about like levitating something or something, it's like up, up and away or something. And so maybe you would say up, up, but you wouldn't want to cast a spell. You would just like talk to whatever it is, like go up, and then if it wouldn't go by itself, you might infuse your words with magic and then say again up, up and away, and then your spell would work because you would infuse those words with your magic. Again, I'm not sure if it makes sense, I'm sorry. But what I wanted to say about the how well it is still in people's minds, how many people think about it, I think that's similar to in a lot of stories, for example fairies or something, they have more power the more people still talk about them. Or I don't really think about a special book or series or anything, but I've heard it often like in TV shows or in books or wherever, that the fairy tale creatures, they're dead now because people don't believe in fairy tales anymore. And before, when people used to believe in fairy tales, those fairy tale creatures had magic and were alive. And it's kind of with this, like with the matching system. So you can create new sayings to use as spells, but they have to be already circulating throughout the population. If it's just something that you just invented, it won't work because there is no magic from the people in it. It's totally weird, and I really cannot describe it. I'm sorry, and I've been on a tangent, and I'm not sure where I was. I've talked about characters, I've talked about a plot, I've talked about the magic system. Yeah, that's pretty much it for the non-spoiler part. I hope you liked it. As I said, really, really rambly. I hope you forgive me for it, or maybe you even like it, I don't know. If you did like it, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, please leave me a comment, tell me if you've read the book or what you think about the book. If you'd like me to do those Harry Potter videos and just ramble on for hours, and yeah, what do you think? So, as for the spoilery part, the mage is evil, which is awesome, which is exactly what I think of Dumbledore. Like, you cannot read the Harry Potter books and see everything that he's doing, or more importantly, that he's not doing, and think he has Harry Potter's best interest in heart. No, he doesn't. And the mage truly doesn't. He doesn't have Simon's well-being at heart. He thinks about the greater good, and more importantly, him being like, him taking over the world, destroying the humdrum as well as the old families, and just him being the evil mastermind, whatever, like, yes, 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 thank you, Rainbow, for, like, validating my beliefs. I feel like that's it, like, yes. As for the humdrum, like, wow, I was really surprised by it. Again, it was something that once Penny, like, had the idea and talked about it to Bess, or Bess had the idea, I don't even remember. Once they got talking about it, I could see it, and it made sense, but I would have never thought about it or thought of it. Like, it was so surprising, and yeah, wow. I really don't know what to say. It's like awesome. And yeah, it's kind of sad that Simon has to lose his magic, but it's also cool to see, like, the vampire with the normal guy who has wings and a tail. Like, that's so funny. And yeah, I really, really loved it. I loved the twist at the end, or both twists, the major one as well as the humdrum Simon one. And I really liked Lucy, or at the beginning I didn't like reading about Lucy because I was like, what the hell is going on? Like, who is she? What the fuck? But I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. But at the end, when it all kind of came together, it was really interesting, and it was kind of cool to see, like, the beginning. And I started believing that Lucy might be Simon's mother pretty early on, but I didn't really make the connection to the mage until it was obvious. Like, I didn't think Davy was the mage until Penny's mom said that Davy was the mage. Like, but I really, really liked it, and I hope you did too. I don't think I've read any negative reviews about this, but still, if you didn't like it, please let me know and tell me why. If you liked it, please let me know. Maybe try not to spoil anyone in the comments if people haven't read it, and, well, after what I've said, probably everyone knows about the mage being evil, but they probably do not know about Simon being the humdrum and whatnot, so don't tell.